We are going full speed ahead. The same speed as walking speed.
Stay tuned to find out how I ended up spending a wonderful weekend with my family from Hong Kong on the Amsterdam Canals. It's coming up. Hi, this is Ken and welcome to my channel, Ken Travels 360. In this video, we are doing something a bit different. Yes, I will be traveling somewhere, but this is somewhat an unplanned trip. Just less than 2 months ago, I found out that my sister and my dad, who live in Hong Kong, were going to the Netherlands for holiday for a week. Due to the COVID policy of Hong Kong in the last 3 years, I haven't really had the chance to go there to visit them. So when I learned of their trip, I checked with my sister to see if there was the possibility to meet up with them for the weekend. Having established the possibility, I then started looking for flights and hotel. Man, are they expensive. For booking at such short notice, I had to be a bit creative. Hotel prices are absolutely crazy. Right, the boarding for the train has now started. I've bought a one-way ticket on Eurostar direct to Amsterdam for £128. This is the first time I've taken the Eurostar to Amsterdam, having done it many times before to Belgium and Paris. Right, this is the car. Just gonna queue to get in now. So I've been allocated a seat in coach 13. And actually my seat number is 13 as well. Just as well, I'm not suspicious. So I just got on board and settled down. The journey is gonna be 4 hours to Amsterdam. After booking all my travel arrangements, I suggested to my sister that we'll keep this visit secret so that I could surprise our dad. Since I should be arriving around 1:15 in the afternoon, we booked a restaurant for lunch. So my sister and my dad will be there first, and then I will come in and surprise him. We have just arrived at Amsterdam Central Station, and now I will make my way to the restaurant to meet them. So as you can see, I brought my GoPro with me and I put it on my backpack mount so I can film the whole process. Well, the weather is actually quite sunny. I've been looking at the forecast all week and it was quite gloomy, and we have arranged a canal boat trip later, so I'm really hoping the weather will hold up. I haven't been in Amsterdam for many years now. Used to come here quite often. You never know if a surprise like this will work out, because I have been keeping in touch with my sister as I arrived at the station. The waiter kept asking her if the third person is coming, so I'm not sure if my dad will understand what they're talking about, but anyway, we're almost there. Right, I'm 90 meters away. It's a restaurant, La Santa Maria. Okay, I can see the restaurant now, La Santa Maria. I'm gonna get in and see what his reaction is. Hey, ah, hey, how are you? Ah, you, you are
Hey, ah,
hey there, it's me from the future after the trip. Were you expecting a different reaction from my dad? Yeah, I was definitely caught off guard too. You know, having lived in the Western society for more than 20 years, I guess I've become accustomed to more open displays of affection. Yes, I have to say I was expecting embracing. But my dad, being a traditional Asian father, has his own unique way of expressing emotions, very subtle and reserved. Despite the initial lack of overt warmth, I realized that his pleasure came from having the entire family gathered together. I observed how he quietly cherished those moments over the next 24 hours, and he spoke volume.
So Pam has just ordered a yarn, Jennifer. You want to try it? Is it strong?
Wow.
Is it nice?
Nice. That's cool.
Let me try it and see how it is like. Hmm. It's okay, that's the first time I have tried Jennifer. So for this afternoon, we are going to do a canal boat trip by ourselves by getting one of these boats.
Most people who visit Amsterdam or the Netherlands will do a boat tour. In fact, my dad and my sister Pam had already done like three of those before I met up with them. Done by many tourists, these boat tours are quite packed and sometimes quite forgettable. I decided that we could do something else that we will probably remember for the rest of our lives. We will hire our own boat and drive it ourselves on the beautiful Amsterdam Canals. We hire it from Boats for Rent, and they are the cheapest operator. I think I pay about 79 euros for 3 hours.
Ooh. Did
you put it in reverse?
Reverse.
Bye.
3 hours is definitely the minimum. Anything less and you will start to feel the time pressure. To make the experience more fun, I bought a captain's hat before the trip so that whoever was piloting the boat could wear it and pose for some memorable photos. We all took turns to pilot the boat, and each of us had to go through a bit of learning curve at first, but we all got the hang of it quite quickly. Each boat can take up to 6 people, and they are very basic and lightweight. You don't need any experience or license. It takes a little bit of practice at first. There is a dial that controls the speed forward or backward. The boat is powered by electric, so it's green and silent. To go left and right, you use the steer at the back. To steer left, you turn it right, and vice versa. It takes a bit of getting used to. The speed of the boat is limited to 5 kilometers per hour, which is basically walking speed. The official speed limit on the canals is 6 kilometers per hour, so we do get overtaken by others.
We are going full speed ahead, the same speed as walking speed.
Hi.
So that's the skinny bridge in front. Right now, after going through a few canals, we're now on the Amstel River. We're gonna keep going this way until the big bridge in front, and then we're gonna U-turn. As you can see, we are really slow. We get overtaken by everyone else.
The magnificent building you're seeing now is the Intercontinental Amstel Amsterdam. And on top of the building, you can see a flag with 3 crosses, which we have spotted elsewhere. This is the official city flag of Amsterdam. What do these 3 crosses represent? The most popular theory is that they represent the 3 dangers of old Amsterdam: fire, floods, and the Black Death, or that they were meant to ward these dangers off. Just when we were turning around, this happened. Another boat cut right in front of us while turning and almost collided with us. And the guy shouted at us as if it was our fault. So we're going through the locks. So we're going through the famous skinny bridge now. So we're just passing the Hermitage Museum. So we just passed the Golden Band that's behind the bridge. The Golden Band is the most prestigious part of the Herengar in Amsterdam. This was where the wealthy merchants built their lavish homes in the 17th century. And it's now where the most coveted canal houses in Amsterdam are. We're almost back at our starting point, and it's time to enjoy the macaroons that my sister bought earlier before I arrive. Thank you for the macaroon. Pam is gonna try to guide us back into the parking spot. Oh, perfectly done. Well, almost perfect. If you enjoy watching this video, please give me a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe to my channel with notifications enabled. That way, you will be notified whenever I release new videos. So we just finished our canal boat trip. I thought that was really fun. I was a bit worried before whether we can really handle going around the canal by ourselves, but it was all right. Okay, we are now taking the ferry F3 to go to the other side. We're crossing the river to visit the top floor of Adam Tower, where there is an observation deck called Adam Lookout. You can get a good panoramic view of Amsterdam and its surrounding there. However, we'll also do its famous swing called Over the Edge. We've already got the tickets, so let's go up. Alright, we've reached the top. The weather had got rather overcast by this time, but the views over Amsterdam is still magnificent. We're actually quite lucky. This was the last day that they were open before they were closing it for a week for renovation. Over the Edge is definitely the main reason to come up here. It swings you out over the edge of the building at a height of about 100 meters above ground. I'm really looking forward to this. I prepared my GoPro on a completely secure wrist mount, but they wouldn't allow me to use it due to revenue protection reasons. But I could leave my GoPro on the ground to shoot upwards. I also asked the friendly people behind us to shoot the footage from behind. So we just tried the swing of Adam Lookout. From here, it doesn't look like that scary or exciting. But when you're up there, first it lifts you up. And at first it's quite gentle and it was quite fun. But then the swing got harder and harder and you can really feel the centrifugal force, and that's when it was really exciting. I tried to keep my eyes open to look at all the views around and I just about managed to. But I think Pam was a bit scared. Okay, 好不好玩啊?
好玩但是很害怕, 離心力很厲害。 點解人哋好似咁容易咁？但係上到去我唔敢擘大眼，好驚。
Right, let's get back down to the indoor area. Here, there are models of the tower and displays about the history of this area, as well as the great views. It's the same view as the outdoors, but it's protected from the elements here. Even from the toilets, you could admire the amazing views outside.There are also some virtual reality rides here as well. After Adam lookout, it's time to cross the IJ River again with the free ferry F3 to get back to central Amsterdam. We then had dinner at a burger joint near the hotel. Afterwards, we took our dad back to the hotel room. Pam and I then went out to enjoy some nice life. We went to the red light district.Seriously, that area is way overrated. We then find a bar to catch up on things in the last few years. Before long, I had to run to go back to the piers by Amsterdam Central Station, as I needed to catch a ferry again. This time, ferry F4, to go to NDSM area, where I've reserved a room in the DoubleTree Hotel at NDSM.Crossing the IJ River again at night is quite magical.
So tonight I'm staying at DoubleTree NDSM Hotel. Gonna show you my room now. It's room 302. Okay, just got in. Yes, the room is not very big, but I have been upgraded to a sea view room.There's a large bed here. I should sleep very soundly, having woken up at 5:40 a.m. this morning. There's really not much to talk about. There's a very small desk here, and you don't even get a sofa.
Finally, let's check out the view. I've been upgraded to a room with water view. Right now, it's so dark, we can't see much outside, but I'll show you the view next time.In the video that will show you what happened on the next day. For now, it's time to say goodnight. It's been a very long day, but I think the adrenaline of meeting my family for the first time in almost 4 years had kept me going till now. Thanks for joining me in this video. See you next time. Ciao.